A new study links a local soda tax with a drop in consumption of sugar-sweetened beverages. KPIX 5's Ann Makovec is live in the newsroom with details of this research in Berkeley.
Now, Kenny, a bottle of this size costs an extra 20 cents in Berkeley, 1 penny per ounce. And with that new tax, lower-income residents have consumed 21% fewer sugar-sweetened drinks. That's according to a new study in the American Journal of Public Health. 1 in 5 respondents said it was indeed that tax that caused them to change their drinking habits. It's an excise tax, which means it's incorporated into the price of an item. The merchant pays it rather than it being added at the register. And that's why some opponents are calling it a grocery tax that can drive up the price of other items.
Because our margin is really low.
I need to make up the price. Only 1 day. Only 1 day.
Those are merchants in Oakland saying they need to make up the price. Well, voters in Oakland have their own sugary beverage tax on the ballot in November. There's a big campaign against it right now, and this study certainly will be fodder for it. It found that less than half of the tax was actually passed to consumers, specifically in the form of higher prices of soda and other sweet drinks. Again, 21% fewer sugary drinks consumed by the study group in Berkeley. And during that same period, people in Oakland and San Francisco drank 4% more. Live in the newsroom, Ann Makovec, KPIX 5.
All right, so Ann, how can Berkeley be a trendsetter with this tax?
Well, Berkeley was the first city in the country to pass a tax like this, though it's been considered in 24 states. San Francisco voters shot it down in 2014, but it is back on the ballot in the city this November as well. Now, I must say, the implementation of this tax was a bit of a mess in Berkeley. The rules were unclear. The cart sort of came before the horse. But now, Berkeley's law could be a real model for other cities. Michelle.
Ann, thank you.